Peggy 12.
A month has passed since the Eurusian declaration of war, and as the conflict escalates...
Hey, Alex. Think there'll be any movement?
We join our correspondent...
No. Chances of regaining control of the space elevator are at 35%.
No, no. I'm talking about the submarine that was missing, and its captain.
No movement in the 215 days since their transfer to the reserve fleet.
And this follows Eurusia effectively declaring most of the Eurusian continent and up to 80% of the IUN bases there to be...
Eurusia's pretty fired up. Are they really going to do nothing with that crazy weapon?
Define crazy. The captain and his ship aren't part of the Eurusian combat doctrine.
Yeah, and that's exactly the problem. Maybe it'd be different if there was some big upset. Just maybe. Ooh, I saw this video at our cafeteria in college. That was 2004, so I was 15.
Both a boast and an analogy, right, David?
This is around the time I got this job.
With our own former President Harling instrumental in the reconstruction project.
Which reminds me, that document's release was slated for this year, no?
No, 2020.
Yes, the Belkan War scandal, in which...
Oh, they're going back quite a bit. You know, I like the crazy weapons of this era. The ones made by the South Belkan Munitions Factory.
They're still giving technical assistance to Eurusia.
And so now, if the Austrian government...
Yeah, the OSEA, too. We're all pawns in their great game. Including this guy. The media got wind of Harling's whereabouts. Whoa, someone just slipped past the space elevator's radar network. Does that raise our chances of success?
No, still 35%.
Well, what if the guy who just flew right in was really crazy?
Define crazy. Still standing at 35%. If you can quantify the uncertainty for me, I can recalculate with higher precision.
Either way, there's gonna be an upset. Things are finally going to move.